Alright, let's check this laptop. There's some stuff in there that was interesting to see. Secure share. What's this about? Amazing share manuscript found, truly amazing. The first time we have a key to some inscriptions from the precursors. Okay. But wait, it gets even better. I immediately saw some suspicious similarities with the ancient languages, so now that I could decipher the glyphs, I dug into our precursor archives even before for more sources. I had to sort through the many different types of writings we found on precursor sites to find more similar to that inscription. It's quite puzzling how many seemingly unrelated writing systems they had. Maybe the precursors are not as monolithic a civilization as we think. Anyway, after more in-depth comparative work, the conclusion is unequivocal. This language is related to ancient languages from the Indo-European family, maybe even others. In fact, given the corpus I have studied, I would say that it is probably an ancestor to them, or at least it has significant influence on them. This is truly fascinating. With that comparative work, I was able to partially understand some of the inscriptions. The one above reads, "When the destruction and death threatens before us, and the solar flare is reaching, the calculator of futures we run. To the calculator of futures we run. I put my findings in the shared folder in case they can be of use to you. Keep me posted find anything else, Anthony." Okay. This is the first part of the manuscript you found in Canterbury. It used a cursive version of the alphabet that appears to be the same one as used in the Voynich manuscript, although the handwriting is clearly different. Translation. Announced on this day, 2161 IE, message from the council. From the lay we cannot do ourselves. We require animals of great strength, limited sense, freedom of action but not thought. To guarantee full control of their behavior, they must be credulous in matters of imagination. They must be suspicious of in matters of fact. They must see patterns where there are none. They must doubt correlations that go against their desires. In all, they must be thought of as our instruments, not our children. Excuse me. They build for us, harvest for us, toil for us, on land, in sea, in the sky. They shall be tools to be used, not creatures to be coddled. On our current father, Yaldabaoth, has given the order to start production. Our current mother, Saklus, has compiled and presented the designs. Our current voice, Samael, has gathered the required talents. Mission begins now. Is this an order sheet for humanity? I can't believe it. Where did Folke get this? Did the order have the knowledge to read this language? Try to find out more if you can, Layla. This is big. This is really big. I informed Mentor Miles. I tried to transcribe pages of the Voynich manuscript. By the way, it's still gibberish. I must use some sort of encryption that precursor boxes can decode. Tablets found in Qobustan, Azerbaijan. Translation. Announced on this day 6/2164 IE. The workmen from this construction site are resigned to the sanitation of the lake, effective now. I'm not sure what this lake refers to. Given the evidence found, we're pretty sure this must be a precursor vault. There must be a precursor vault there, and this message seems to confirm it. Unfortunately, we haven't found it yet. Maybe this will help. Okay. Serengeti, Tanzania. What was true is untrue. What was done is undone. It is a war, not a rebellion. All are summoned to fight. Okay. Here are transliterations and translations for two inscriptions you found in the vault near beneath Stonehenge. Okay. In the war and in law, there is only one goal: the search for a better future. Lug the polymath. Another one. Fate is what the weak name their cowardice, the strong craft their own future. Morrigan. Not sure what to make of these. Do they relate to things you've seen on site? Not entirely, to be honest. I must admit, I do recognize Morrigan the name more than anything else, but I think that's in reference to other stuff, to be fair, so probably might be reading too much into that. Beast I found in Jerusalem. The sun shone warmly inside, a burning sight. Now I soothe the wound in the lake of tears. An example of precursor poetry? And a pretty sad one at that. Note that the original text follows a meter of 16 moray per verse. Okay, not sure what that means. I'm sure someone explained it if they understand in the comments. Tell us found in Xi'an, China. I apologize. I know I've butchered that. A bunch of shovels, axes, plows. Lock or hide them. I suspect theft from inside. Shells, axes, and plows? What precursors use such rudimental tools given their advanced technology? Or did they keep the technology away from their human slaves? So many things we don't know about them. Okay. St. Brendan. Stone guard, given the Lord, gate find this way. Okay, so these are basically all of them. So, well, I'll tell you what, because we've already gone through them in the game, if you'd like to read further, please pause the video and read them for yourself if you'd like, because we've already had them. They've already been vocally said for us, so if you'd like to read them, please just pause the video. I'll just go through each part slowly. Give it a chance. Sometimes I do this, it's just easier, so especially if I already hadn't said it, it allows people who haven't quite got the order yet just the chance to actually read them for themselves, to catch up and just understand what's going on. I feel that's only fair. Cool. I think going through this. That's just the fragments. If you haven't actually seen this, I'll play this for you quickly. And then we'll move on. So these are each of the Norse gods, as you'll notice. They basically pass down their knowledge as in like in sort of like a spirit form, I suppose, if you like. So a smaller version of Yggdrasil, passing down their knowledge and memories. So seeing that, you know, Odin, Freya, Thor, Tyr, you know, they, oh, by the way, in this one, in this clip, Odin basically forbade Loki from doing this, but yes, you'll see that Loki doesn't take kindly to being told to piss off. So Loki fights them and gets his memory back and transfers his mind in. So does that successfully, and then leaves. So I'll show you that. Now I can head off. I just want to show people in case they weren't aware of how I might have figured stuff out already to this time. That whole video based, like, I had some assumptions. That just confirmed everything for me. So, yeah. Let's head off, Sean. I'm ready.
I'm ready.
It's a long way to Beantown. Hop in.
If my theory is correct, it also connects the Monday with a couple of aspects. I can't remember what Layla was called, or was that... Oh, excuse me. Or was that Cassandra? The Lexios, whichever character he chose.
Sean,
whatever gender character he chose.
Ah, good. Your signal's already a little wobbly. Are you inside?
Not yet, but there's 100 feet of ice above me.
All right, we may lose touch when you push through, so remember what we talked about. Watch your meters carefully, for radiation especially, and keep the staff close.
Got it.
Standing by.
The staff of Hermes Trismegistus. I kind of love saying that name, to be honest. The whole name of the staff.
Zawahoe Nakwat, Unzme Burturwan di Quarde, Ul Solus Vras Hunakudide, Unzum Huraz, Vesdere has, Zohumsi.
I swear that language is so damn similar to the one. Because if you remember the village where Connor's from.
I'm in.
Understood.
I hear you.
I swear that's so similar, if not the same language or of the same origin,
the elevator still works.
75,000 years. What's another millennium or two?
Practically, yeah. But it makes me wonder if the languages are related.
Yes, by our reckoning, it's going to go up by about 16 degrees Celsius.
How does it draw so much power?
Tectonics is our best theory. The movements of the Earth's crust. Churning lava beneath. Huge source of energy.
Yeah, geothermal.
That's tech humans
yeah.
should have. Energy, not pieces of Eden.
Well, when all this is over, we can get a startup going, you know? Get a little work-based bioband. Just the three of us.
Shit. You're breaking up, Sean.
Say that again, please. You're breaking up.
Forget it. I'll call you when I'm topside.
Why don't you try calling us when you're topside? Something like that.
Here we go.
Yeah, you basically agree with that, so... Yeah, it's just all everything's just gone to shit basically, but kind of makes yeah. There was a name that got that was said, but the language that they that these Isu languages, it sounds so. I might be mistaken, but it sounds so similar to the one to the language used by the native tribe of Connor. It sounds so damn similar. Like, I'm not even kidding.
There you are.
Or at least certain.
You're working overtime.
Or at least certain words sound incredibly familiar. Or sound so similar that
must have collapsed when the ice melted.
Wow, let me get a god, look at that glowing red. So either there's so much either that's I think that's on that whole thing's on overdrive, isn't it? It's basically going to overload, essentially. It's basically been given so much power it doesn't know what to do with it, so it's hyping up the magnetic field, I'm assuming. Okay. Oh god, this thing again.
Whoa, whoa.
Oh god.
Steady.
Now! That'll work. At least that one was simpler.
A pool of water. From all that melted ice.
Okay. Oh, it's just one of these small. I thought it was like a deep. I hate these deep canyons. You can't see the bottom. Okay, so I'm guessing we can't go through that field. Go underneath here. I just saw the gap down. Like, yeah, that's got to be the way. Yep. This place is seriously hypercharged with energy. Like, wow. Like, ridiculously hypercharged with energy.
Don't look down. Don't look down.
No kidding. Oh. Okay, I saw the ladder thing. I'm thinking that's where we're gonna go. Holy shit! Oh my god! Okay, yeah, this place is taking some serious geothermal energy. Well, it may not be exactly that, but the closest, you know, I mean, we use geothermal energy in places on Earth. That's a huge. That's basically just geothermal energy just shunting itself into this structure. Like that's overdrive basically. No wonder the magnetic field's just gone over. It's had basically a 1000% power boost. Wow! My god. Time has not been friendly to this thing. At all. Whoops. Not that. Up again, Layla. Uh-huh. Wow, look at this place, man. This is huge. Reminds me of the scale, but actually, this is a hell of a lot bigger than Atlantis. Although, to be fair, they're having to put a site inside a place that can drill into geothermal energy. Or there, or something like that. Wow. This is quite colossal, actually. That's where we fought Sigurd. Why the hell do I keep on saying Sigurd? But Bassim, you numpty think. Good God, man.
Why would anyone want to end their life here, unless they felt it was just beginning?
Uh-huh. Oh god, that got to me. That's Bassim. Yep. If what I think is gonna happens...
It's just like the animus.
Oh, you should be paying more attention, Layla. That is stupid of you. She should be paying a lot more attention. I blame Layla on that one. I do.
This is Eivor's Valhalla. Or a simulation of it. So what am I looking for? Will I know it when I see it?
Hopefully.
Something feels off.
I don't think we're supposed to get in there, are we?
What is this?
Oh. Ah, this is those, the Sisters of Fortune.
Are you doing this? Are you pushing this machine to its limit?
Past, present, and future. Yep.
So here
the three aspects of time, past, present, and future. And this is, I'm guessing, where Bastion's gonna manipulate us. I wonder how he's gonna do it.
Who's your master? Is he here?
Of course he is.
They flatter me. I am only a guest in their world. A world spun of wishes and hopes.
You're low-key, asshole.
Bassim, you sent the message. You led us to Eivor's grave.
Yes. A hopeful message, was it not?
How? You've been trapped here for a millennium. Eivor put you here.
Indeed. But I'm not alone in this place. Not always. I have a friend who helps me. Together, we read the calculations. After we located Eivor's probable resting place, I contacted you. Through the digital lattice that enwebs this earth like a spider's nest. In our day, all the world was connected like this. A superorganism of technology. The staff you carry, the temples you have visited, all of it speaks as one. May I show you something?
You could try.
I imagine you can do anything you want in this place.
Basically.
Not as much as you might think. I am tethered to my body in a most uncomfortable way.
Obviously.
But you can slow this machine down. You know how it works.
Yes. We'll do it together. For another catastrophe is near at hand. This node of time has an ugly way of correcting itself. Go ahead.
He's basically trying to spin.
You're
a
hard man to trust. You must know that.
No kidding.
You're not obliged to trust me. But this is all I can offer.
Our typical Loki spinning his
God
way.
Damn it.
We don't have a choice, do we? Probably screwed ourselves in the process, I'd imagine. Oh, that ugly grin on his face.
Verdandi, Skald, be at ease. Your day of rest has come.
At peace. At last, we rest.
Is that it? Is it done?
From it, I think.
Basim! Where are you?
What is that?
I think we just freed Basim, didn't we? And allows him to get his life back. Wow. Okay. Alright, so, okay, so, if that's, the whole, if that's,
wipe everything, run it again.
Oh, you're one of those people who read time, I've heard about you.
Nothing. No. Layla. Hello.
Of course he knows who that is.
Yes. Through the calculations I read here in the Grey. 8 years ago, the odds of your arrival were 15,055,003,276 to 1. As the years passed by, those odds improved. And as of yesterday, near even. It's a pleasure to meet you at last.
Who are you? And what is this?
Oh, no, reads time.
I am the reader of the calculations. All these possible futures for you and the world outside.
I remember this from Origins.
I have spent much of my new life reading these, searching for a way to finish everything we started so long ago. It begins here. You slow down this machine and save the world, from which point all possible futures expand. Millions upon millions of possible roads. But in every one, another catastrophe recurs. The node collapses and the world is wiped out. The human race dwindles and fades. I must keep looking. I must find the solution for you. I must leave you with something.
This node. This is right now where I slow down this machine?
Yes. I start all my calculations from this point. The only thing I know for certain.
That seems limiting.
How do you mean?
What if you went back further, to 2012 when Desmond saved the world?
Desmond?
What if he didn't save the world? What if he walked away and let the world burn? Look at those timelines. Read them instead.
I see.
Fair point.
An interesting idea. Fascinating. Billions upon billions of new timelines to explore.
Exactly. These are timelines that never came to pass, but they could have. If Desmond had let the world be destroyed, maybe the humans that survived would have learned something from the disaster. And maybe in one of those timelines, they could have found a way to prevent it from happening ever again.
That is brilliant. How did you come to that idea?
But you didn't think
if you spend
that.
Too much time narrowing down what's possible, you may never give another thought to the improbable.
Thank you for your insights, Layla.
It's only the beginning. We have a lot of data to sift through.
Are you staying?
Until we find something useful, I will. I don't want this to happen ever again.
You may not have much time, Layla. The machine is powered down, but the radiation, it will linger for decades. By my calculations, you have 73 seconds before your exposure.
Yeah, because you don't have the staff.
I'm not worried. I have the staff of Eden. It heals and protects.
Yeah, but you don't have it with you.
You do not.
Exactly, don't have it with you.
What? How?
Wake up, Layla. You don't have it on you.
Of course.
Of course.
Fuck. All right. We'll find a solution together.
She's staying.
However long it takes. And if that means I can never leave, so be it.
Wow. Okay. That I didn't anticipate
from
her.
I owe this to the people I hurt. The people I love.
Yes. I know the feeling.
Let's get going, huh? A few billion timelines might take a while.
It will. But it will not feel like it. That is what I like about this place.
That's not Desmond. It sounds vaguely, but it's not Desmond. Well, if so, then... why did they not confirm he was Desmond? That's what I find weird. It is! It's Alethea! That confirms it! The staff of Hermistris Megitus was Alethea! And Alethea's life forces gave Loki his life back. Drew Bassin. Got it! It's the only thing that makes sense.
I'm with you.
Yep.
It worked perfectly, my dear.
Is the mad one here?
No, my love. Only we remain.
And Layla.
The heir.
Oh, that was her name.
Of memories. Fulfilled her role perfectly.
Or preordained.
Now then, a new world awaits.
Okay.
Sean, Bex, I had a choice, and I chose to stay. You'll wonder where I am. You might wonder if I am. I don't know how to answer that, but I'm not afraid. And I'm not alone. We have work to do. Work that may take us days or years. It's impossible to say. But we'll finish it. What I mean is, don't come looking for me. It's too dangerous and too late. Take care of yourself. Take care of the world we still have. And take care of...
You see, she's fine. In a manner of speaking.
A manner of speaking? Jesus! We have to find her!
Would not be an
You heard her. She doesn't want to be rescued.
Bullshit.
Well said,
in any
Rebecca.
Case, there's nothing left to save. Not after this long.
Because of you! You left her there!
This is all a bit much. I know I'm in the same situation.
No, you're in a class all your own, man.
I see Backstreet just take him straight on. I love it.
We're assassins now, not hidden ones.
Yep.
from the Arabic, Hashishin.
Ah, I figure that's where it was from. Of course.
Ah, and do we have a mentor? Is that still the practice?
William Miles.
Name?
William Miles.
Desmond. William Miles.
Father Desmond Miles.
I'd like to meet William Miles. Would you bring him to me?
We can call him. Encrypted line. You can talk to him right now.
No technology. Face to face. A meeting of minds. It's time to take the fight to these Templars, as you call them. I won't go anywhere, my friends. Your animus is in good hands.
Bex is pissed.
How much do you know?
My dear, we invented such things long, long before you did. I'll figure it out.
Okay.
Bex is seriously pissed. I don't blame her, to be honest. Don't blame her at all.
It's a nice place to die, Eivor. Not everyone gets to choose.
True.
You bested me. I don't know how, but you did. Yet, I'm the one left standing.
Cruel irony, really.
And now, I can take from you anything I want.
True.
Your memories, your skills, your secrets. They're all mine. And when I have them, I will put them to good use, to find my children, and bring my family back together.
To steal the memory, steal the skills of a Viking, as Loki he is, trade himself up better, and go off to find, to try and bring back the body of Agraboda, or Aletheia, Aletheia, find Jormungandr, Fenrir, and I always forget who the other kid is. Huh. Okay. Right.
A quiet place to find an end. I almost envy you.
What an asshole. He has his own agenda. Be fair. He's Loki. He's an Isu Loki. I mean, what, like... He doesn't care. I want to see... Now, apparently I heard that there's some sort of cameo if you sit on a bench out here. I'm not sure if that's really going to happen or not, but, see if that's really
true. The wonderful smell of wood smoke. I'm glad some things never change.
The wait? A specific spot I'm supposed to sit in. Does it matter? Read someone's a cameo here. I'm supposed to wait a certain length of time. Okay, that cameo is not going to work. By the way, the cameo was that you saw a figure here, sitting there. That was the cameo. All I read, so. Don't know why that's not working, unless that's something afterwards, not sure about. Okay. Alright then, well, I'll tell you what, we'll end this here, because quite likely, unless of course, well, we actually have to go after, Alfred, don't we? So, yeah. let me just do... Says anything.
Magical.
Okay.
Is it wishful thinking to believe this device has a thought interface? Do I really have to use my hands and voice?
Oh, God's sake. Wow. I'm just curious if he says anything. Oh, yeah, things over here.
Well done, young man. You were onto something.
Young man? Altaïs, we know the word Altaïs. A lot of time with Bastion now together with Hytham. Young man. Oh, is that being with Eivor, quite possibly? Eivor or Hytham, quite possibly. But, yeah, paste down for this with Marmaid, managed change to activate the use of temples, and the mass ejection dolls. Years ago, felt going over stronger, now will maintain feel across the machine because it's better overclocked. Yeah, essentially. Okay. Alright, wow. So, okay then. So, interesting. So, if that really was Desmond Miles, I mean, I have my doubts, but if it was, it kind of makes sense. I mean, to be fair, you can make the same argument. It could be Subject 16. I know it's far-fetched, but let's face it. Although, the one thing that does tie Desmond into the possibly reading that is the fact that he touched the aura and he disappeared, died, but is that could have taken his aura, his life force, which makes sense in that regard. It did look similar to him. But also the fact that he said he's recently become the reader. Now, the thing that I took from that as well is that... excuse me. About the whole thing explaining that was that... when we went to sites in Egypt... there were different people talking about different... or at least a narrator, different narrator, talking about different aspects of time and everything. Like how that operated. And there were people who read time, read aspects of calculations and that sort of thing. And I think there were more than one person who did that. So whether it's different fabrics of reality which they read, I'm not really sure. But if that was Desmond, that's a cool cameo in that regard. I have my doubts, but there are two references that would make sense in that regard. Have my doubts, but if it's him, cool. If it's not... he's an Isu that's a reader, and he's just been retasked, so, yeah, it is what it is. Alright, so, I find it strange because I can't believe that we're going to play next game as Basim. As Loki. I don't believe for once, I'd be shocked if we're going to play next game as Basim in the modern world. It would make more sense if we're going to play as William Miles. That would actually make a lot of sense. I'd be really surprised if that was... because that's taking it to a whole new level with an actual Isu in the Animus. I mean, to be fair, I don't like the way Ubisoft are taking this, if that's the way my theory is going down that route. Anyway, I'll explain all that more at the end, which could be next time. Yeah, we'll see. But it looks like we're pretty much at the end. Just got to take out Alfred and do one or two things. So yeah, I will catch you next time.